on today's episode, The Rebirth of American Iron. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Pittsburgh is the American city normally associated with steelmaking, but in fact there are several U.S. cities that are associated with the metal. A major one is Gary, Indiana. Now, Gary lies on the southern shore of Lake Michigan, some 25 miles from downtown Chicago, and by 1960, it was home to 178,000 people. Now, steelmaking was the primary industry, but the well-known effects of outsourcing and cheap imported steel decimated the U.S. primary steel business. And by 2020, the population of Gary had fallen to 69,000. While Gary has often been held up as the poster child for American deindustrialization, steelmaking never entirely left the city, and in a significant move for U.S. primary production, United States Steel announced a major investment in the company's Gary Works, a new pig iron caster. Now, pigging, as the industry calls it, is the precursor to steelmaking, the fundamental process where iron ore is heated in furnaces in a reducing chemical environment to strip the oxygen from iron oxides to produce iron. The iron itself is the primary raw material for steelmaking, which reduces and homogenizes the iron's carbon content and adds alloying metals. The pigging operation will feed U.S. Steel's integrated conventional and electric arc mini mill operations. So what makes it significant? Well, for decades, primary steelmaking has been declining in America, with low-cost Asian producers replacing American mills for commodity steels and basic structural shapes. The U.S. steel industry moved to electric arc mini mill technology using scrap steel as a primary input, remelting it and alloying it to make higher value-added steel products. The economic theory was that the U.S. industry would move up the value chain and leave low-margin commodity steelmaking to others. The weakness in this strategy is that the overall system still requires primary steelmaking to create the inputs for the mini mills, steel which travels over a very long supply line. While the low cost of production has given foreign producers a traditional advantage, the COVID-19 disruption of supply chains has shown that local and regional shortages of product can generate wild swings in market prices. End users in major industries like construction and automaking may be willing to pay a price premium for reliable supply. Moving product across an ocean comes with inherent risks. The Gary operation's economics are driven by the pigging operation's primary input, iron ore. U.S. Steel owns two major Minnesota-based ore operations, Mintac and Keetac, a short haul by bulk carrier on Lake Michigan. The pig iron supply is expected to account for about half the input needs for the company's Arkansas Big River Steelworks. The new $60 million operation is expected to start up in early 2023, and as importantly, it represents a commitment to steelmaking at the Gary Works, which currently employs almost 4,000. The reshoring of manufacturing in America has largely been associated with tech-related industries, such as integrated circuit manufacturing and the assembly of personal electronic devices. But the fundamental enabling technology of any industrial nation is primary steelmaking. Today, a new generation of electric arc furnaces are now harnessed for primary production. Modern processes, plus a guaranteed and reliable domestic supply of iron ore and metallurgical coal, plus supply chain security and lower pollution than overseas producers, plus local quality control, may give the U.S. industry a unique selling proposition compared to low-cost overseas commodity product. And the mini mills converting scrap into higher value steels will still be there. But in the future, they may be fed by inputs with traceability back to mines in places like Minnesota and Wisconsin. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.